I'm still here. Hello, everyone. In the previous video, we discussed an essay's introduction. In this video, we'll discuss an essay's body paragraphs. As in the previous video, I'm going to lay out the structure of the body of a close reading essay and then demonstrate how that structure would apply to an actual close reading essay. As I mentioned in the previous video as well, different instructors use different terminologies for discussing essay structure. My terminology might not be the same as your previous instructor's, but this should all be essentially familiar to you from English 110. So, an essay begins with an introduction that contains a general topic, a specific approach, a thesis statement, and an indication of the essay's significance. That will probably be your first or maybe your first two paragraphs. After the introduction come the body paragraphs. An essay can have as many body paragraphs as it needs to. You might have been taught in high school that an essay should have three body paragraphs. An essay can have three body paragraphs, but it should have as many body paragraphs as it needs. It could have 6, 7, 8, 29, 88. It depends on the thesis the essay is arguing, how many body paragraphs it takes to argue that thesis well. Now, what is the purpose of those body paragraphs? The purpose of most body paragraphs is to argue a claim. A claim is an interpretive statement that advances one aspect of the thesis. If the overall argument of your essay is the thesis statement, then the claims are the various sub-arguments that, when you put them together, establish the thesis. They're the smaller arguments that, put together, make up your big argument. The body paragraphs that argue these claims need to contain a few things. They need to contain a topic sentence, in which you clearly state what the claim of the body paragraph is, and evidence for that claim, which is material to support the claim and explanation of the relevance of that material. That is the basic structure of an essay, although you should also always add a conclusion, in which you sum up what you've said and maybe reflect on its significance a bit more. That, again, might seem abstract and maybe also daunting to you, but it's really a way to help you organize your thoughts about a literary text into a focused essay. So, let's talk about how you might take the thoughts you've had about a literary text you've close read and fit them into that basic structure. For your close reading essay, you can write about any of the short stories we've read so far this semester, except for the very short story, In a House Besieged. However, we close read that story very carefully, and we discussed it at length on Blackboard. So let's consider how we might write a close reading essay about In a House Besieged. As noted in the previous video, the general topic for the close reading essay is how we think about the future. In this video, the specific approach will be close reading In a House Besieged, and the significance of this essay will be that close reading this story might lead us to new ideas about how human beings think about the future, which is a major component of human thought in general. So now, what's left for our introduction is we have to come up with a thesis statement, or at least a rough draft of a thesis statement. The thesis statement will depend on what we discovered or noticed about the short story as we close read it, and what interpretation of the story we eventually came to. Those things will be different for everyone, since everyone reads literary texts differently and has different reactions to them. If you remember the video on In a House Besieged, what really struck me as I close read the story was that even in the middle of this frightening situation, when the woman and the man didn't know what was outside of their house causing the sounds of explosions or what might happen to them next, the woman and the man nevertheless seemed to be dealing with problems in their relationship, and their relationship even seemed to be falling apart. Their fears about what might happen to them seemed to me to reveal their conflict and intensify it. So I might, after thinking about this for a while, come up with a thesis statement something like, Lydia Davis's short story In a House Besieged demonstrates how fears of the future can reveal and intensify present conflicts. Is that the greatest thesis statement in the world? No, but it's pretty good. It tells us what Lydia Davis's short story might suggest about how human beings think about the future. So let's say that's the thesis statement. Lydia Davis's short story In a House Besieged demonstrates how fears of the future can reveal and intensify present conflicts. To make that big argument, my essay is going to have to make three smaller arguments: that the woman and the man are afraid of the future, that their fears of the future reveal that they are in conflict, and that their fears of the future are also making their conflict worse. Those three smaller arguments will be the essay's claims. An essay's thesis statement should essentially tell your reader what your claims are going to be. But your thesis statement will also tell you what your claims are going to be. After you come up with a thesis statement, or a rough draft of a thesis statement, you will see what parts of that thesis statement you are going to have to argue in the claims in the body of your essay. Basically, any remark in your thesis statement that would not be immediately evident to anyone who read the story will have to be argued as a claim in the body of your essay. For instance, In a House Besieged tells you that the man and the woman are in this house hearing explosions and they're frightened. And that's basically it. You're gonna have to argue that the man and the woman are afraid of what we can call the future, that they are in conflict, and that their conflict is getting worse. Those things would not be immediately evident to anyone who read the story. So how do you argue these claims? Let's take them one by one. The first claim is, the woman and the man are afraid of the future. Well, first, you'll want to make sure that this paragraph on this claim has a topic sentence. Somewhere near the beginning of the paragraph, there needs to be a sentence that clearly states the claim this paragraph is going to argue. The topic sentence could be, the woman and the man are afraid of the future. Or it could be something more stylish, like, whatever is causing the sounds of explosions outside the house, the woman and the man are frightened by their uncertain future. Whatever it is, it needs to state the claim very clearly and in one of the first few sentences of the paragraph, so your reader knows what claim the rest of the paragraph is going to support. What is the rest of the paragraph going to contain? Evidence for the claim, to argue the claim, to convince your reader of the claim. In different kinds of essays, the evidence will be different. If you're writing a scientific essay, the evidence will probably come from scientific experiments or statistics or scientific articles. Or, thinking back to Roland Barthes' essay, if your essay is about how French adults perceive children, the evidence could be descriptions of various kinds of French toys made for children by adults. You'll be writing a close reading essay, so the evidence, all of it, comes from the literary text you are close reading. The evidence will consist of what you noticed about the text when you close read it. You might provide a quote from the text and explain how that quote supports your claim, or you might describe an aspect of the text, like the structure of one of its paragraphs, and explain how that aspect of the text supports your claim. So what evidence from In a House Besieged would you cite to argue the claim that the woman and the man are afraid of the future? You might write about how the woman and the man cower, suggesting that they are really quite terrified. You might write about how their dialogue consists of sentence fragments, indicating that they're panicking. And then you might write about how they offer wildly different explanations for the sounds of the explosions, suggesting they have no idea what's causing them, suggesting they have no idea what might be coming toward them, or what might happen to them next, in the future. You might write about all of these pieces of evidence in one paragraph, or you might break them up into several paragraphs in succession, each one focusing on analyzing a different piece of evidence. But taken together, this evidence from the text, which is based on your close reading, will argue that the woman and the man are really afraid of what might be coming toward them, of the future, which to them is very uncertain. Then move on to the next claim. Their fears of the future reveal they are in conflict. Here, for evidence, you might write about how the woman suggests that natural causes are causing the sounds of explosions in order to try to calm herself down, it seems. How the man contradicts her by suggesting causes that are quite dangerous, and how his contradictions suggest he's antagonizing her, maybe even tormenting her. You write about how these pieces of textual evidence suggest that the woman and the man are not united as they face the frightening future together. He's exploiting the frightening situation as a way, maybe, to hurt her. Whatever is going on outside the house, it's bringing to light conflicts between them that have probably already existed. Finally, for the last claim, their fears of the future are making their conflict worse. What evidence would you use? Well, maybe the last sentence suggests that the woman no longer feels at home with the man, suggesting she's losing her sense of home in the middle of this conflict. The last sentence also shifts to her perspective to suggest that her point of view is very separate from the man's point of view. There's an increasing separation between them. And last, maybe, the house is described as besieged by someone or something. That could be the man. Not only have they been in conflict for a while, but the man now seems to be like someone even attacking the home. As you explain these pieces of evidence, you're explaining how the frightening future is intensifying the woman and the man's conflict. Now, if we zoom out again, we have the basic structure of a close reading essay. We have an introductory paragraph that indicates the essay's general topic and its specific approach, and offers a clear thesis statement, and somehow hints at the thesis statement's significance. And the rest of the essay is broken down into body paragraphs, each of which argues a claim and supports that claim with evidence from the text of the story. Finally, there is a conclusion in which you might reflect further on the significance of the essay, or reflect further on the relationship between fear and the future and conflicts between people, or maybe raise another bigger idea that future essays might touch on. What I recommend is that before you start writing your essay, you produce an outline like this one, where you write out your thesis statement and claims and make maybe a bullet-pointed list of all the textual evidence you're going to use to support those claims. Then, when you begin to write, you follow the outline like a map. What you're doing as you write is basically explaining this outline to your reader. You're turning this outline into complete sentences that explain what you mean by each claim and that explain how each piece of textual evidence supports each claim. Now, everyone writes differently. You might come up with a thesis statement first and then the claims, or you might come up with a few different claims about the text and then group a few of them together into a thesis statement, or you might list things about the text you noticed in your close reading and group those together and put them into different kinds of claims, and at the very end of the process, come up with a thesis statement. But if somewhere in the process you produce an outline like the one we just did, you'll ensure that your essay has a clear structure. And you'll also always know where you're going as you write. You might also end up communicating interesting new ideas that a single short story can give us about how we human beings think about the future.